start by chanting the Om and the Guru Mantra. Inhale deeply. Om. Traditional understanding of yoga, Thursday is dedicated to the Guru. Guru is a teacher or a guide. So we said we will have a normal class with asanas and pranayama and everything, but we will also talk about the importance of today in the life of a yogi, a yoga student, a yoga practitioner. So today we will talk briefly, I don't know how brief that will be, about the Guru principle. Because this is the most important understanding when it comes to the yoga as such. Have you heard of the word Guru? Now there are many ideas about this word Guru. Some like it, some don't like it. And that's why I want to open this topic. Now, before we started, we chanted a mantra called Guru Mantra. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo, Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat, Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah. Now, whenever I teach or my students teach, they will always begin with this mantra. Why? Because this mantra is dedicated to the Guru. Whoever your Guru is. Why? It's because whenever somebody teaches yoga, it is very important to understand and remind themselves that whatever we are teaching as yoga teachers or whatever the students are learning as yoga students, they are teaching and learning because of something called as a tradition of guru-disciple relationship. For thousands of years, the knowledge of yoga, the wisdom transfer or the knowledge exchange has been happening through a very beautiful system of transmitting the information, the message, the inspiration, the wisdom from the guru, the teacher, to the student. If this tradition of passing the wisdom from the teacher to the student was not there, we would not be doing what we are doing today. So whenever we start a class or a teaching process by chanting the Guru Mantra, we remind ourselves that yes, I am part of this beautiful tradition that has been alive for thousands of years. And because I am part of this tradition, I need to be humble. I need to have humility to just pass on what has been given to me by the teacher. When this humility is there in your teaching, the ego will not dominate. If the humility is not there in your teaching, what will happen? The ego will dominate. And remember, the ego will always want to be better than the other. That's why in last 3000 years of yoga history, there have not been many innovations. I can hardly count 8 to 10 innovations in the innovation means creating something new. Nothing new has been created in the field of yoga. If something new was created, it was only saying the same thing in just a different way, looking at the audience in the front. But in last 20 or 30 years of yoga history, we see so many innovations. Why? There are more styles of yoga coming up every year than have come up in last 3000 years. Why is that so? It's because of this. The current understanding of yoga is, or yoga teacher, every yoga teacher wants to be better than the other yoga teacher. So they will innovate something new. And to innovate, they will add something that perhaps is not a part of yoga. Just to be better, or just to perhaps have a better business model. And this is exactly where humility is needed. Because it's not how much you teach as yoga teacher or even as yoga students, remember. It's not how much you teach as a yoga teacher that counts, is how you teach is what counts. A yoga teacher is not a performer, which unfortunately the current yoga teacher has become. A current yoga teacher in the yoga industry has become a performer. Performer means what? The yoga teacher has to innovate. Every 3 months, every 6 months, something new, some new pose, some new name, some new style. Otherwise, your yoga teacher will not be in the market anymore, because somebody else will do a better headstand and nobody will look at your Instagram post. No, this is, I'm being very honest. The narrative of yoga is changing very fast. So somewhere, every yoga teacher needs to ask themselves, am I a yoga performer or a yoga teacher? Because performers will change. Why? For example, you go to stand-up comedy. Stand-up comedy? Translation? Okay. Stand-up comedy, you have to come up with new jokes. Otherwise, audience say, oh, this is the same joke like last year. So the yoga teacher is also under that compulsive pressure. Oh, I need to create a new posture, new, something new. Otherwise, my students will go to the other teacher. Why this is happening is because the humility is lost. You are not teaching anything new. That's why yoga is as basic like as brushing your teeth, having the bath, or eating. 3000 years ago, a mother taught the child to eat in exactly the same way as a mother today teaches the child. And if we want to keep our humility in teaching the yoga process, we need to understand that there's a valid method, a valid way of transformation or transfer of knowledge between the guru and the disciple. Is clear? So the reason we chant the Guru Mantra before is to come down into humility. If this humility is lost, the ego will dominate. If ego dominates, I don't know what we will be doing under the name of yoga after 100 years.